in terms of climate modeling. Usually we have four components: atmosphere, ocean, land, and sea ice. And each component have individual models. We try to merge based on a couple model we call. So basically try to merge in the all components and working together. So it takes almost one year to finish entire model experiments. And we finish model experiments and to analyze the results, and we found soil moisture is kind of predictable for a couple of years. So we apply this idea to evaluate stream flow predictability in the Colorado River. And we found our model have a good skill to predict year-to-year variability of Colorado River water supply. And we also analyze the source of the predictability, where it's coming from. And we finally found long-term memory coming from the ocean. So ocean have more lower frequency variability, pretty slow variability. And this kind of slow modulation affects the atmospheric variability, and then it's kind of shift of the probability. We found tropical Pacific, Atlantic, and North Pacific, those kind of almost global ocean, some kind of pattern that one affect to the Colorado River. So our drought prediction can provide more long-term perspective. And then if we know we have a water shortage, so in the case, we need to work with the policymaker, and then they need to regulate how to allocate current available water resources.
A two-year lead time on drought could have just huge impacts for farmers. So if they know a drought is coming in 2 years or 3 years, it just kind of helps them plan out their business, plan out their crop rotations.
So this could be really useful for wildfires. I think it needs a little bit more work and development to see if it's going to be can be turned into an actual prediction system, but if it could be, it would be a really neat advancement.